most people think that you can put a stick into the ground and watch its shadow for a while and get an accurate east-west line. This is a very common belief, and the reason for this is that there are millions of YouTube videos, websites, books, magazines, you name it, they all say the same thing. If you put a stick into the ground, mark the end of the shadow, wait for a short while and then mark it again, the line between the two marks will be east-west. Is this true? No. Unless you get incredibly lucky, it's never going to give you an accurate east-west line. Now, some people will say it's useful in a survival situation. And this basically means, okay, I know it doesn't really work, but it'll give you a rough idea of east-west. And when you're thinking about survival, you know, close enough is okay. But if that's all you want, a rough idea, you don't need to start putting sticks in the ground and watching the, you know, shadows move and hanging around for ages. If you can see a shadow on a stick, then you must be able to see the sun. So you can just imagine pointing the hour hand of a clock at the sun. And if you're in the northern hemisphere, halfway between the hour hand and 12 is roughly south. And if you're in the southern hemisphere, you just reverse that process, job done. And that would give you enough to work in a survival situation. It's just as accurate as watching a shadow on a stick, and it's about 1,000 times quicker. Plus, you don't have to carry a stick around with you in your pocket. At the moment, it's 9 o'clock in the morning, the sun is in that direction, so that way is 12, so south is halfway between the two, that way is approximately south, you know. So a sun stick compass, it doesn't really work the way that everybody tells you that it does. You know, on every other video and website and even training manuals. But today, just for you, I'll show you how to use a gnomon in a way that it will give you an accurate east-west line. It's getting really hot here. I don't know about you, but I would be extremely skeptical about anybody who tells you that the entire internet is wrong and they're correct. So I want you to be able to check what I'm saying and confirm it's correct for yourself. Don't just take my word for it. In fact, I would suggest that you should never believe what anyone says on YouTube until you've checked it out for yourself. And yes, I do know that's rather strange. I'm asking you to believe me when I say that you shouldn't believe me. How does that work? Who knows? Anyway, the only thing that you'll need to repeat this process for yourself is a stick. And who knows, once you've checked it, you may find out that the entire internet is right and I'm wrong. So let's find out. Let's go through how it's normally shown on YouTube videos. The first thing I'll do is I'll put the stick into the ground. Then I'll mark the exact point at the end of the stick's shadow. Some experts say to wait for 15 or 20 minutes, but it's more accurate if you wait for longer. So I'll wait for about an hour. Next, I'll mark the exact point at the new end of the shadow. Obviously, if I had a compass, I wouldn't need to put a stick in the ground. But you know, come on, bear with me. This is just for a video. So I'll check the line with the compass, and the line on the ground shows what's called a true direction, but the compass points in a magnetic direction. So I'm not going to go too much into that today, but I've adjusted my compass for the difference. This is normally called the local magnetic declination, and in this area it's 3.5 degrees west. Oh, if you're not used to using a compass, what I'm doing here is I'm going to set the W underneath the index mark. That's the little line that you can see here. When the compass is pointing west, the needle should sit directly over the large red arrow inside the dial. And as you can see, it doesn't work. It doesn't point east-west. I find this quite surprising when so many websites told me that it would work. Okay, you know, let's be fair. It is pointing vaguely east-west, but it's not accurate. And it took me over an hour to get the same direction, which I could have got in just a few seconds by looking at where the sun is. Sorry, I'm going to have to keep my sunglasses on because the sun is right in my face. So now let's do it again properly. But once again, don't believe it just because I'm saying it. Go through each step yourself and try and replicate it and test it. You'll need a stick, any stick will do. But here's the thing, it doesn't have to be of any special length or thickness or even straight. It really doesn't matter. I don't know why. I think some people just invent procedures and rules to make it sound more complicated than it really is. It's actually a really simple thing to do. Once again, don't believe me just because I'm saying it. Try it yourself with different types of sticks and you'll see that the shape and the size make absolutely no difference. Any old stick will do. As long as you can clearly see the end of its shadow, that's the only important thing. Oh, and for this method to work, you'll need something to measure the shadow. So you can use anything, an old bootlace, the edge of a map, or you know, whatever you happen to have. Today, I'll just be using another stick, just because it makes it easy. So here's how it works if you want it to get an accurate east-west line. In the morning, put your stick into the ground on a sunny, level spot. That's your gnomon, the stick. This next step, you don't really need to do, but I just find it easier. Mark where the end of the shadow falls, and then I'll use the second stick to trace out a part of a circle around the base of the stick. And then all you need to do is wait. Go and have a coffee, or obviously if you're in the UK, go and have a cup of tea. As you can see, the shadow got shorter towards solar noon and then longer again afterwards. Oh, just a quick point here, by the way. In most parts of the world, solar noon is different from 12 o'clock midday, so just bear that in mind. The tip of the shadow is now touching the line again, so we'll mark this spot, and what we'll do is we will, if I can get this stick in, there you go, that's in. And what we're going to do is we're going to put a line between the two markers and hopefully it worked. Let's have a look. So we'll put a line between the two. Oops, doesn't matter about this stick now. We're done with that. So it's just the markers that we're interested in. So there you go. There's a nice straight line. I'll put a weight on this end. Keep it nice and tense, taut. Right, that's straight. Won't get my stick, won't. Stay in the ground, there it is. So, now, the test. Let's use a compass. Oh, make sure it's actually touching the markers. Let's use a compass to actually check the direction of this line. Is the needle directly over the red arrow in the inside the dial? I'll get the camera and I'll bring it in. As you can see, it's worked here, and this method will work virtually anywhere on Earth, any day of the year. Obviously, there is one exception. It won't work ever in the UK, as we only get one sunny day every 50 years. And that's it. Two marks, same shadow length, one before solar noon and one after, and you've got yourself an accurate east-west line. And yeah. Yes, as you can see, I am the world's first hybrid, half human, half zebra. So look at the difference in this. So kids, when your mum tells you to wear sunscreen, do it or you'll end up looking like this. And I can see the difference. I don't know. I've been a ski instructor in the winter and I've worked outdoors in the summer for decades, so this is what happens. So the obvious question is, why does this method work when the other one doesn't? It's all to do with how the sun moves across the sky and the curve formed by the shadows. The shape of the curve depends mostly on the time of year and how far away you are from the equator. But other things such as the time of day, your altitude, etc., etc., these also change how the arc will look. So if you just mark the tip of a shadow and wait a bit and then mark it again, you're actually joining two random points on a curve. Sometimes that line will be close to east-west or maybe even exactly, but many times it'll be way off. It's basically luck. But the length of the shadow is symmetrical either side of the solar noon. So in the morning, as the sun rises, the shadow gets longer and then shorter and shorter until midday. And then in the afternoon, it lengthens again. And at some point, it will be exactly the same length that it was earlier on in the morning. We all know that the sun rises and sets in different positions depending on the time of year. But that doesn't change this symmetry. Those two equal lengths of shadow points are always perfect mirror images of each other, one before noon and one after. So if you join the lines between them, it's always true east and west. Not magnetic east and west, but true east and west. There's no guesswork, there's no luck, it just works virtually anywhere on Earth, any day of the year. So there you have it. The only way a gnomon or a sunstick compass works accurately, and if you've ever seen the other method online, now you'll know why they fail. Okay, so we've seen how to get a proper, correct, accurate east-west line, but that immediately raises another question. Why would you ever actually need to use something like this? After all, as I said before, if you can see a shadow, you must be able to see the sun. So it's a fair point. But there are a number of valid reasons. As an example, once you've found a reliable east-west line, you can use that to set your stick, and then you can mark the north-south line as well. And this gives you a fixed cross on the ground, which doesn't move when the sun arcs across the sky. And that's why it's useful, for the simple reason is it doesn't move. Let's imagine that you're searching for something, a location, an object, or even a missing person. You can use your fixed cross on the ground as your base point. For an example, you walk 25 paces east, and if you don't find what you're looking for, mark that spot with, I don't know, an upturned stone or a broken branch or whatever you have, and then return to your base point. Next, try 25 paces north, and then west and south. And if you still haven't found what you're looking for, repeat the process northwest, southwest, southeast, etc., etc. And if it still doesn't work, do it again, but this time at 50 paces. Each time, come back to your base point, your cross that you've made on the floor. So this is just a very simple expanding search pattern. I've actually made a separate video explaining how to do this search pattern in much more detail. I'll put the link in the description box. So yes, there are times when having an approximate cardinal points really can be useful. Oh, one quick thing before I go. Does anybody know where this video was filmed? I'll give you a big clue. If I want to sail from here to New York, following a standard rum line on a Mercator projection, I'd go on a bearing of 285 degrees true for around 2,900 nautical miles. If I followed a great circle, it'd be slightly shorter at around 2,790 nautical miles. But if you're going to have a go at working out where I am, don't forget that a nautical mile is only 1850 meters, but a standard mile is 1610 meters. So bear that in mind. So let me know in the comments if you know where this video was filmed. Thanks for watching.